Hello, Odooers, and welcome back. Today, we're taking a look at the manufacturing app to see how one-step manufacturing works. When using one-step manufacturing to produce a product, Odoo creates a manufacturing order but does not create a transfer order for the movement of components to the production location, nor does it create one to move finished products to the location where they are stored. Product counts still update based on the amounts used or produced, but there's no need to worry about validating transfers. This makes it a great option for companies with smaller inventory and manufacturing operations. Don't worry though, if you want to create transfer orders for those stock movements, you can always enable two or three-step manufacturing, which we'll cover in the next tutorial. But for now, let's dive into our database to see how manufacturing in one step works in Odoo. First off, I'd like to mention that Odoo enables one-step manufacturing by default. However, I want to quickly show you where that setting is enabled, just in case it's been changed for some reason. So let's go to the inventory app and let's click on the configuration subheading and select warehouses. Then I'll select main warehouse to open its setting page. In the manufacturer field on the bottom right, I can select the number of manufacturing steps used for the warehouse. As you can see, manufacture one step has already been enabled. Great. Now, we do have one more setting we need to worry about, which is work orders. Work orders allow us to break our manufacturing orders down into smaller operations, which can be carried out at different work centers. All you need to do for that is to jump into the manufacturing app. So let's jump into here, click on the configuration subheading and settings. Then I'll enable the checkbox next to work orders here at the top, which you can see I've already done. And don't forget to save it too. Awesome. Okay, now we're ready to start manufacturing some products. So let's select on the operations subheading and click on manufacturing orders. As you can see here, I've already created two MOs for our coat rack product in advance, so we can skip right to the fun part. Now, there are two ways to process an MO in Odoo, from the MO itself and from the shop floor module. Let's use the first manufacturing order as an example of processing an order on the MO itself. On the MO, we can see that the components required to manufacture the coat rack under the Components tab. By clicking on the Work Orders tab, we can see the work order operations that need to be performed to manufacture the product. In this case, we have two work orders, drill pull and insert dowels, which are carried out at two different work centers as we can see here in the Work Center column. In the status column, we can see that the first work order is ready while the second work order is waiting for another WO, since we need to complete the drill pull work order first. To process a work order, all I need to do is click Start to begin at the work center and Done when I'm finished. Pretty simple, right? Once I do that, the work order status changed to Finished, and the next work order status changed to Ready. So I'll just complete the second work order the same way that I completed the first, so I'll click Start and Done. Great. Now that all the work orders have been completed, we can close the MO by clicking the Produce All button at the top of the page. Awesome, we've just produced one unit of our coat rack product. Now, I want to show you how to complete the same workflow using the shop floor module. So let's jump into there to see how that's done. So I'm going to go back to the dashboard and click on Shop Floor. The Shop Floor module is great because it allows your manufacturing employees to see an overview of every MO, as well as the work orders assigned to each work center. For a full overview of the module, make sure to check out the Shop Floor overview video, which I'll link down below. Okay, right now we just have one MO for our second coat rack. The MO lists its first work order, drill pull, and I can see that the work center where it's scheduled to be carried by clicking on the Drill Station 1 button. After completing the order, I just need to click Mark as Done, which causes the work order to fade away. Once it disappears completely, the next work order appears at its assigned work center. We can go there by clicking on the Assembly 1 station here at the top. And let's go ahead and mark as done as well. Since this is the final work order for the MO, a Close Production button appears. This button has the same effect as the Produce All button on the MO itself. I'll click it now to close the MO. And boom, that's another coat rack ready to be sent to a lucky customer. Once again, we find ourselves at the end of another incredible Odoo tutorial. Today, we learned about one-step manufacturing and walked through two different ways to complete a manufacturing order using one-step. Join us next time and we'll get you up to speed on manufacturing products using two- and three-step manufacturing. See you in the next one, Odooers.